Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve question number 9 of exercise 10. And this question, you are given a triangle ABC which has an isosceles triangle with side AB is equal to AC and D, E and F are the midpoints of side BC, AB and AC respectively. You have to prove that the line segment AD is perpendicular to EF and is bisected by it. Means this line you have to prove is perpendicular on this, means you have to prove that these two angles are of 90 degrees, then only this will be perpendicular. And when we are talking about bisecting it, means if this point is O, then you have to prove that AO is equals to OF, then only this line will be bisected. Now to do so, what we have to do is, first of all we have to prove triangle ADB and triangle ADC as congruent. Then by the property of parallel lines, we will prove that this angle is equal to this angle, and if this is 90, then this will also be 90. Then we will prove that this will be bisected. So let's first of all prove that triangle ABD and triangle ADC are congruent. For that, AB is equal to AC is given to you, because triangle ABC is isosceles and these two sides are equal. And if this side is equal to this side, so clearly this angle must be equal to this angle. This is because there is a property of triangle that angle opposite to equal sides are also equal. So we can say that A, angle A, B, D should be equal to angle A, C, D. This is because angle opposite to equal sides are also equal. So this is because of this property. Now the third thing is, because it is given that D is the midpoint, means this BD and DC must be equal. So we can say that BD is equal to DC. This is because D is the midpoint. Now in this triangle ABD and in this triangle ACD, this side is equal to this side, this angle is equal to this angle, and this side is equal to this side. So by side, angle, side, these two triangles are congruent. So triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ADC by side, angle, side property. So then if these two triangles are congruent, so clearly they're all other parts, or you can say the other sides and angles must be equal. So we can say that this angle must be equal to this angle. So if the value of this angle is x, so clearly the value of this angle must be equal to x. Or I can say that angle ADB must be equal to angle ADC. This is because of CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. So these two angles are equal, and if this is a straight line, so obviously this plus this must be equal to 180 degree. So angle X plus angle X must be equal to 180 degree. So twice of X must be equal to 180 degree, and angle X must be equal to 90 degree. You can cancel it out, the value of X will become 90 degree. So the value of X here, it is 90 degree. Now from midpoint theorem, this and this are given as midpoints, and if we join these midpoints, so clearly by midpoint theorem this line must be parallel to this line. So EF must be parallel to BC, and this is the transversal. So angle this must be equal to angle this. These are corresponding angles on the same side of the transversal, and above the parallel lines. So clearly, if this angle is equal to 90 degree, so clearly this must be also equal to 90 degree. So we can say this angle is also of 90 degree. So if this angle is 90 degree, so clearly this AD is perpendicular on EF. So EF is parallel to VC. This is by midpoint theorem. Because if we join the midpoints, the line is parallel to the third line. So clearly angle AOF must be equal to angle ADC, which is of 90 degree. So by this we can say that AD is perpendicular on AEF. So this is the sign for perpendicular. This is the first part we have proved. Now we have to prove that this line also bisects EF. For that we have to prove that EO is equal to OF. For that we have to prove that these two triangles are congruent. Then only these two sides must be equal. And to prove so, what we can do is, this angle and this angle are equal, and clearly this angle and this angle must also be equal, because we have proved that triangle ADB is congruent to ADC. So clearly this angle must be equal to this angle, which we have proved here. So I can write here that angle BAD, which is this angle, this one, must be equal to angle DAC. This is by CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. Now let's prove that triangle AEO and triangle AOF are congruent. For that, I prove that this angle is equal to this angle. So angle BAD is equal to angle DAC. This is the first angle, means this angle is equal to this angle. This AO is common in both the triangles. So this AO is equal to AO. This is common. And at the last, these two angles are also equal. Both are of 90 degree. So I can say that angle AOE is equal to angle AOF, which are both right angles, or you can say both 90 degrees. So by angle side angle, because both two angles, these two angles and one side is common in both the triangles, so triangle AEO must be congruent to triangle AOF. This is because of angle side angle property. So if these two triangles are congruent, so clearly their other parts must also be equal. So other parts, which are EO, must be equals to OF. So if EO is equals to OF, means this AD also bisects this EF. So this is how you can solve these questions. Thank you.